Hello and welcome to MIDAS Tutorials. In this tutorial I'm going to give you a guide of how to find your way around MIDAS, a brief overview of the user interface. So we'll start by logging in, and when you're logged in you'll see a screen similar to this. Now I've logged in using the default visual theme. If you've logged in using a different theme, the icons may appear slightly different and you may see different colours and backgrounds and things. Also, if you're logging in from a mobile device, the layout may be slightly different. So let's start in the top left corner of the screen. This is our navigation calendar, and we use it to view different dates in the booking grid. We can also navigate forward and backwards between months or years. And clicking the Today button will always bring us back to the current day. Beneath the calendar is what's called the Booking Information panel. Now this has up to three tabs: Booking, History and Client. Whenever we hover over a booking in our booking grid, the display changes to show us information about that booking. If we move away from the booking, the information disappears. If we toggle the little pin icon, then hover over a booking, if we then move away from the booking, the information stays. So the Booking tab gives us information about the booking. The History tab gives us information about the history of the booking, when it was added, who added it, when it was last modified and so forth. And the Client tab gives us information about the client that the booking is for, including previous and future dates the client also has bookings on. And we can click on any of those to jump to those dates instantly. Let's go back to today. So that's the Booking Information panel and the navigation calendar on the left. To the right of the navigation calendar at the top, we see the currently selected date. Beneath that, it tells us who we're logged in as. We can also log out, change our password, get help, which will open the documentation. We can also switch to full screen mode. Beneath that is the main booking grid. This shows our venues vertically stacked and times across the horizontal axes. By default, it shows us one day at a time from midnight to midnight. You'll see though, we have a selector here, which will allow us to increase the number of days we're viewing. So if I select 3 days, then you'll see we're viewing 3 days worth of bookings within our booking grid. And this goes all the way up to 8 weeks. Let's go back to a single day view. So the current time of day is also indicated in the booking grid by this red vertical line. Bookings themselves can be clicked, and you'll be presented with additional options to modify or delete the booking or generate invoices. And these are covered in separate tutorials. Above the booking grid, in the top right corner of the screen, are a series of icons. You may see some or all of these depending on the user permissions that have been assigned to you. Currently shown here, the first icon allows us to add new bookings. The second icon allows us to approve or reject pending booking requests. The third icon is your notification center, showing you reminders and watch notifications and so forth. Then we have a search icon, which allows us to search for bookings or clients or invoices. The recent activity log is a log of all user activity that's occurred within MIDAS. Statistics allows us to view graphical statistics and reports into our venue usage and bookings and clients. Print allows us to print bookings if we left click, and there's additional print options available if we right click. This icon allows us to access the invoicing capabilities of MIDAS. The cog icon allows us to alter program settings. And the final icon shown here is the emergency evacuation data button, which if we click that will print out a list of who's on our site right now and whereabouts they are. Incidentally, the little red numbers you see on some of these icons indicate the number of events you can access through them. For example, the 2 on the pending booking requests icon means there are 2 pending booking requests outstanding. The 14 here means there are 14 notifications waiting for me. And the 13 plus here indicates that there is at least 13 people on site right now. Beneath the main toolbar icons are the view options. The drop-down selector allows us to filter the booking grid. Show all will show all our venues. In use will hide all those venues that don't have any bookings in for the currently selected date or data range. Clients will change the view to group bookings by clients instead of venue. And if we have defined any other venue groups, they will also appear in this list. Adjacent to that are four smaller icons. This one, if we click it, allows us to unlock the booking grid for editing. If we unlock the booking grid, we can then drag and drop bookings around the grid to either move them or duplicate them. And this is covered in a further tutorial. The little question mark icon here will toggle the display of any pending booking requests. So if I toggle that, you can see there's a booking request at 9 p.m. tonight, and I can approve or reject this directly from the grid instead of having to go via the pending booking request screen. So that icon toggles the display of those. And the next icon toggles a display of any deleted bookings. So any bookings that have been deleted, I can toggle their display in the booking grid also. And the final icon will either jump us back to the booking grid if we're on one of the other screens, or if we're already on the booking grid, it will toggle between a daily view and a monthly view. Thanks for watching, and please do check out some of our other video tutorials online.